Title this morning is Let's Stomp on Satan's Head. Will you please put your hands together for Sister Deborah Hayman?
Who came in with a problem today? And who in here has a great big care? And who is saying, Lord, do what you want to do with me? It doesn't matter who stops and stares. For I've done all I know to do, you're saying, and it's still getting the best of me. In fact, it almost made me forget my Lord and Savior, that you can make me free. So before we let that happen to you, my friends, there's something to be done and said. So if you're ready for a breakthrough today, let's stomp on Satan's head. Oh, let's stomp on Satan's head in here. Not step, for that's a little too nice. For the one who is trying to destroy us and our relationship with Jesus Christ. So let's stomp on Satan's head for trying to cause us to doubt. When God has already told us, my friends, that our battles are already fought. Come on, let's stomp on Satan's head for trying to make us afraid. When God told us, keep going, my children, for your paths are already made. And somebody has a lot of cares this morning that should have been left at the door. But you're going to let go and let God in here while holding on to what's in store. No, I'm not saying we don't have problems. For this week alone, you say, don't ask. But this is not the time, my friends, today to become reserved in God and relax. But let's stomp on Satan's head. Yes, somebody needs to stand and stomp. For you've been withstanding some mighty blows lately. Great bruises and hard bumps. Oh, but you have the victory today in Jesus. So come on and stomp on his head. For that last curve he thought would take you out. But look at you. You're not dead. And come on, let God strengthen you. No, this fight isn't over yet. And for you have great things in store in him. So let's get all God said to give. For we know these trials are trying, but we also remember what God said, that the victory is ours, great God, mighty, great people of God. So let's stomp on Satan's head.
Come on and stomp on the head of the devil. Come on and stomp on his head. Come on and put your feet down on the floor and stomp on his head. My God gives us the victory. Amen. Come on and put your hands together and glorify God in this place. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. My God. In every trial and every tribulation, remember we win. We have this victory. Why do we have this victory? We have this victory because we have Jesus Christ. We have the one, hallelujah, who has all power and authority on our side. Come on and glorify God in this place. Amen. Amen. Thank God for Sister Deborah Hayman. Amen. Are you mad? Anybody mad at the devil? After hearing this poem, are you mad at the devil? Are you ready to fight? My God, my God. Hallelujah. We thank God, amen, for such a word of encouragement. Will you please put your hands together for Sister Deborah Hayman? Amen. I feel like I can fight a little bit better, a little bit more, a little bit longer. I feel like I can stay in the fight a little bit longer. I feel like I can go on and see what the end's going to be. I feel like I have this victory in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Now at this time, we're going to call for the Solomon Temple Reason Brothers. Amen. As they come and minister and dance. Put your hands together for Justin and Jordan Reason.
Hallelujah. Oh. This is not just a worship experience. Oh, but the people of God are being empowered tonight. Oh, like never. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, lift up your hands, church. I'll declare it again. The people of God are being empowered tonight. Hallelujah. How many want His power tonight? How many want His glory tonight? Somebody, God's renewing your passion for ministry tonight.
Like never before.
like never before, like never before. Won't you fall in this place? Won't you fall in this place? Somebody just
won't you fall in this place?
Not just the building, not just the room,
but won't you fall?
Wonderful young men. Amen, amen. At this time, I want everybody to stand up on your feet, and we're getting ready to bring our man to God. How many ready for the word of God? Amen. We're so glad time has been spent, but we're so glad to be here this morning and so glad to be blessed of the Lord. Amen. Have you had a wonderful week? Amen. And if you had any problems, guess what? You're going to get rid of them this morning. Isn't that right? You're in the right place at the right time to hear the right word with the right God to get your problems solved. At this time, let us receive our visionary, our missionary, our bishop, our apostle, the Reverend, the doctor, the Bishop James Holloway.
Come on, give me a hand, praise. Let's worship God here. Oh, that's a spirit of worship. If you just worship him and praise him, he's in this place. If you want more, y'all lift your voice and say, Lord, I thank you for more. I'm asking for more of you, God, more of your grace, more of your mercy, more of your love, God. I need more to stand in such an hour as this. Father, we love you, we praise you, we thank you, we give you glory now. We say, Lord, have your way in this place. For God, we know that we're in the right place at the right time. It is you that have ordered our steps today to be here. And we give you glory for it now. And mean, God, whatever we need, you're going to meet the need. The need shall be met according to your divine word. So we say, Holy Ghost, have your way today. Break down yokes, break your habits, break rebellion, break stubbornness. Bind those spirits in the name of Jesus. Bind unfaithfulness in the name of Jesus. But release, God, the power of God to deliver and to set the captive free. We thank you now, and we praise you, Holy Ghost, have your way. And God, you take over, we decrease, you increase in Jesus' name. Come on, let's just worship God. Come on, let's just worship him and praise him. Come on, just worship him and just praise God for just a moment. Let's spend some time just worshiping him. Tell him how much you love him, how much you need him. Just talk to God in your own way. Lord, you are the strength of my life. God, I love you, I praise you, I adore you. And I lift up holy hands in this sanctuary. And I thank you, God, for your goodness. And I thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your love, God, ongoing. You didn't stop loving us, but you keep on loving us. You keep on helping us. You keep on directing us. And for this, God, we're just going to worship you and just praise you and give you glory in the house. Come on, somebody need to thank him. Somebody didn't praise God like they should have. Somebody to give God the glory. Let's do his name. And God, let's do worship and praise. Hallelujah. Couldn't have made it without you. Couldn't have made it without you. Somebody laid down, didn't even get up this morning. But you blessed us to get up again. And for that, God, we said thank you. You gave us activities of our limb. For that, we said thank you. We got up, God, we had a mind to reason and a mind to give you praise. Hallelujah. So I can help but thank you this morning. Just because you're young don't mean you got up on your own strength. It was God who got you up. Give God a praise, everybody. Hallelujah. Come on, give him a praise. Hallelujah. You may be seated. You may be seated if you can. Oh, bless his name. Bless the awesome God, the mighty God, the one that's able to correct every crooked place. We give God praise today for Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Can you say amen? Our soon coming King. Praise God. We want to thank God this morning for the fragrance of the house. First Lady, give God a praise for her. Prophetess Linda D. Holloway, praise God. And all the saints in the house today, we thank God for all the visitors. We thank God for you. If you took a prayer cloth, if you sold into the radio ministry this morning, I want to make sure that I put a piece of prayer robe in your hand before service over with. Can you say amen? You may look at our mission this morning, and our mission is to exalt the only begotten Son of God, which is Jesus Christ our Lord, to reach out to every man spiritually, physically, emotionally, and educationally, regardless of race, creed, or color, and share the love of the Holy Father and his redemptive work on the cross until his future return to earth in power and glory. Can you say amen? We praise God. We want to encourage you also. Make sure, because we care about families, we care about our neighborhood, we care about people who don't have anything. So make sure all the members know their commitment about the canned goods, bring them in, get them in, because we're feeding about close to about 500 families this Christmas, I know. We want to make sure that some family have some food. There's some children not in Africa, not in India, but right here in St. Louis, can you say amen, in this neighborhood that don't have food. So we want to make sure We do our part as a church, as a ministry. We are not just enclosed, but we are a ministry that care about our neighborhood. Won't you say amen? We want to read this morning in the Word of God, in the book of Acts chapter 16, verse 25 down to verse 34. In the book of Acts chapter 4 and verse 31. In the book of Acts chapter 5, verse 19 and verse 20. Our last scripture, the book of Acts chapter 12, verse 7 and verse 8. Can you say amen? It's important that we understand faithfulness is contagious, but unfaithfulness is destruction. When you are not faithful to what God has called you to do, you're really heading for destruction on your own. And I'm imperative thinking how important it is, since we see the day of the hour in which we live, that Jesus shows us all the signs of his coming and how people can be unfaithful to the work of God, unfaithful to Jesus Christ, who brought you, who keeps you, who blesses you. And I want to encourage the saints, be faithful in classes, be faithful in Sunday school. And I said to the minister, and I said to all, amen, if you're not faithful in Sunday school and in teaching, you should not be in any auxiliary. Can you say amen? There's no need of putting you in something and you're not getting saved. It all is all about what? Souls. It's all about souls. You cannot live in sin and still say you saved. Can you say amen? No man can serve two masters. This morning, though, we're reading in the scriptures, and as we read, we'll be coming back to a lot of stuff God began to share with me concerning the message this morning, not only just dealing with Paul and Silas, amen, but dealing with the body of Christ and how important it is that we're here today by divine appointment. Look, somebody say, I'm here by divine appointment. It's no accident that I'm here. Not only that I'm a member here, but there are visitors that come, and sometimes visitors come, they don't understand. They just thought, well, I just go and visit. So I must tell them, well, I just stopped by. Somebody invited me, but I got news for you. You are by divine appointment to be here today to hear what God's got to say to you and to the body of Christ. God always, if you're in him, he always must order our steps in his word. God ordered the steps of the saints. And the Bible says every word of God is sure. And meaning that God said, when I lead you or direct you, it's going to be solid ground and solid foundation. And so today we're talking about Paul and Silas. We're going to be dealing with a lot of other things with them. But I do want to read that starting with Acts chapter 16, verse 25 down to verse 34.
And at midnight.
And the Bible said, and I can just stop right there and preach from there. And at midnight.
Paul and Silas prayed.
Uh-huh.
And sang praises unto God.
Yes.
And the prisoners heard them.
And the Bible said the prisoners heard them. Now we're talking about midnight. It simply means, midnight here means intense darkness or gloom. That sometime at the highest point of our experience, we go through some dark things. Amen. But we know weeping may endure for the night, but joy must come in the morning. But we're talking about midnight here, the middle of the night. Amen. Praise God. And the number 12 here means government or divine appointment. So may I tell you, you have the divine appointment. As you walk with God, God said there's some divine appointments that you cannot escape. There's some things that you cannot escape. There's some things that you must go through the process to bring you to maturity. Can you say amen? And it's important that we understand when you walk with God and obey God that you don't belong to you. You belong to God. Look, somebody says, I belong to God. I'm God's property. Can you say me? He saved me. He filled me. I'm born again. I'm covered by the blood. I don't belong to me, but I belong to him who purchased me. So praise God this morning. God has a right divinely to place you where he want to place you, to use you the way he want to use you, that the glory may be his and his alone. Won't you say amen? Praise God. And also some words I want to deal with. The word kata, K-A-T-A, means toward something. The word misos means middle. And the word nux, N-U-X, means night. Toward the middle of the night, God began to speak. God know how to speak.
even in the intense darkness of one's life. Read what it says. They were praying for, I'm coming back to all and read on it more, but the Bible said they were in prison and they were there because of obeying God. They were obeying God, and God, the Romans and those in that area, amen, got upset with them because they dealt with a woman, amen, that had a spirit of divination, amen, a woman to predict. And the spirit of divination is the spirit that people predict, but it's not God. But this woman, early in the scriptures, we're talking about these are the men of God that show us the way of salvation. It's true, but it was coming from the wrong spirit. And you say, amen, God, he make the devil tell the truth every now and then. But the spirit there is really called the occult of Apollo, amen, because he dealt and cast out and destroyed the god of Python. And because of that, amen, it became now the occult of Apollo. So what she had was the spirit of Apollo using her. Won't y'all say amen? Lord have mercy. So you got to be careful about where you go and what you do and who you connect yourself to. Read what it says.
And suddenly, there was a great earthquake.
Uh-huh.
So that the foundations of the prison were shaken.
And the Bible said, and suddenly there was an earthquake. And how many know we need some earthquakes? Not just natural earthquakes. We need some spiritual shake-up. But everything that happened natural, it always happens spiritual. So if there's any type of earthquakes going on and flood, stuff is going on too in the spirit the same way. Praise God. But the Bible said they were there, and suddenly, we're going to be talking about all this, suddenly there was an earthquake so that the foundation of the prison was what?
Shaken.
Now, if the foundation of something is shaken, it better be strong. Every person in the body of Christ, you better make sure your foundation is built on nothing but Jesus and nothing else. Build upon the word of the living God, because if it's not built upon Jesus and the word, if your foundation is shaken, guess what? You're going to be shaken. Read.
And immediately, all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loose.
Read.
And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep, and seeing the prison door open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled.
He was accountable for the prisoners. He was accountable for watching them. And he knew by the Romans' law that if he allowed them to escape, that they would not accept any excuses, they would immediately kill him. Read.
But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying,
yes,
do thyself no harm, for we are all here.
Read.
Then he called for a light and sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved?
He understood that the things that happened was not normal. He understood that I don't have what you have. We're going to talk about all this in a moment. I don't have what you have. So, sir, what must I do to be saved? And I asked the church, you got to ask, what must I do to be saved? Not just joining the church. You got to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. There are a lot of people sitting in our congregation and churches don't have no relationship with Jesus. They come out of duty. They come out of whatever they come out of, but they're not coming because they have a relationship with you. When you have a relationship with Jesus, amen, your whole attitude, your whole lifestyle changes. Read.
And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.
Believe on the Lord Jesus, and thou shalt be saved. Believe, he said. You must believe. Amen. And it shouldn't be in the house of God and you don't believe. You shouldn't be up in here and you don't believe. Because if you believe, there's a change. Read.
And thy house.
And your whole house will be changed.
And they spake unto him the word of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And to all that were in his house.
Yes.
And he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes and was baptized, he and all his, straightway.
Mm-hmm.
And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all his heart.
And believe with God with all of his what? Not just him, but God wanted to make the whole house whole. And it can't be whole if we're practicing sin. The people of God, we cannot be practicing sin and living like we married and we not married. Y'all talk to me. Living in the same house, doing the same thing, and don't have, and God has not, and listen, God, it may still hate sin. God does not honor shacking, common law. He only honors marriages. I want y'all to say amen. He is married to us. We married to him. And God required that if you're in the body of Christ, amen, you got to make sure you got your business straight. Praise God. Now let me go to some, go to the book of Acts chapter 4 and verse 31. Look up, look, somebody said, by divine appointment.
By divine appointment.
Acts 4 and 31.
And when they had prayed.
And when the Bible said, and when they had prayed.
The place was shaken where they were assembled together.
And the place was shaken. So look at the power of prayer. Look at the power of prayer if we'll pray. Read.
And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost.
And the Bible said, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And that's what's lacking in my churches. In churches everywhere, people want to come and they don't want to be filled. How many know we got to be filled with the Holy Ghost? We got to be born again. Won't y'all say amen? You're not going to make it and stand before the presence of God and not filled with the Holy Ghost. Read.
And they spake the word of God.
And they spake the word of God.
With boldness.
And they spoke it with boldness because the Holy Ghost was in them and they couldn't help but speak boldness. Matter of fact, we have tarrying service every Sunday ongoing to the rest of the year at 5 o'clock. But those ain't got the Holy Ghost, we're going in the tarry room. We're going to pray until you get the Holy Ghost. Can you say amen? Every demon that's in you, every rebellious spirit in you, every lying spirit got to come out because God wants you filled with the Holy Ghost. Read in the book of Acts chapter 5, verse 19 and verse 20.
But the angel of the Lord by night.
And the angel, God always, when God would do things, many times he would send angels, and the angel will always come, and they will always have assignment. Read.
Open the prison door.
And the Bible said, and the angels opened up the prison doors.
And brought them forth and said.
And said.
Go stand. And speak in the temple to the people.
Uh-huh.
All the words of this life.
Yes. Speaking to them all that I've said. Speaking to them all that the word is said to you. They put you in for one reason. He said, but I'm going to get you out so you can continue on the work I've called you to do. And I don't care. Nobody should be able to stop you from doing what God has called you to do. If you understand divine appointment, God's already got things set up for you so you can get the job done. Read. In Acts chapter 12, verse 7 and verse 8.
And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him.
Uh-huh.
And a light shined in the prison. And he smote Peter on the side and raised him up, and saying, arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hands. And the angel said unto him, gird thyself and bind on thy sandals. And so he did. And he said unto him, cast thy garment about thee and follow me.
And follow me. All these examples when the angels get involved. When prayer is being offered, when prayer is really intense, angels get involved. When there's really prayer and praise, angels show up. Can you say amen? If we the people of God begin to worship and praise God, he sent angels in our midst. Amen. To bring deliverance and help into the body of Christ. We want to start talking about the important, amen, how important it is. And verse number, I'm going back to verse number one, divine appointment. I'm going to verse one, when the Bible says divine appointment. And in divine appointment, there's always going to be manifestation. Somebody said manifestation. And what God's got to manifest something, if it's a divine appointment, God has to manifest his glory. Verse one, go back again and read it. We're going to go with scripture because here, not only am I going to give you what the scripture is saying here, but also I'm going to give you the number, what it means. Read what it says.
Verse 25.
And
at midnight.
And we're in chapter 16.
And at
midnight.
Paul and Silas prayed.
Mm-hmm.
And sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them.
And the prisoners did what? There's something about prayer and praise. If it's really anointed, if it's really divine, it's got to be heard. Won't you say amen? Also, hearing number one, he's talking about sudden shifts. When you begin to pray and really begin to praise God, there will be shifts going on in the atmosphere. and shifts going on even in you, and shifts going in the atmosphere where you are. So your praying and your praise is not in vain. But God is shifting something for us in the Spirit of God. Also, the number one means here, it means unity. When you get prayer and praise together, it brings about unity, it brings about strength, and it brings about also a shifting as well. Can you say amen? How many times have you prayed, and when you got through praying, God began to do things? How many times you begin to just praise God and worship Him, and before you got through, God changed things? Because there's things happen when you begin to pray and praise God. Praise God. Number verse 26, even the Bible talks about they opened doors. Read that again.
And suddenly, there was a great earthquake.
Yeah.
So that the foundations of the prisons were shaken.
Uh-huh.
And immediately all the doors were opened.
And when the prayer is made, when fasting is, when prayer and praise is going forth, God not only would bring about earthquake or change, but God also will show that anything that's bound will be loose. Anything that's closed will be open. Come on here. You got to understand that door has been closed for years. But as you begin to learn how to worship Him and how to praise God, we're seeing now doors open for us. Opportunities coming, amen, toward for you that the enemy said you'll never get it. You'll never go in that level. But God said through prayer and praise, now I'm opening up doors. That's why our prayers are not in vain. That's why your praise is not in vain. That's why you pray all you got to pray. Pray everywhere you go. And praise God any chance you get. Because you got to understand, while I'm doing things, doors are opening for me. Doors are opening for my children. Doors are opening for the ministry. Doors are open, amen, financially. And these doors will be open, but they're not automatically going to be open until the saints start doing their part. Can you say amen? Read. Now the next verse.
And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open,
yes,
he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled.
And he would have killed himself. And verse 3 also means repentance. Amen. He said, he realized I need something, and he repented. Amen. And the number 3 means, amen, divine God was in it. And anytime God is in something, He has to bring deliverance. God don't get involved in nothing unless He changes things. And here, amen, God began to change it, meaning God will make it complete. Can you say amen? That's verse number 27, right?
Yes.
And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword, would have what? Killed himself, supposing that what? The prisoners had fled. But God said, I'm in this thing, even though it looked like it looked bad, it looked like nothing going to really happen come out of this. God said, I'm in it. And how many know sometimes God's in stuff, and we thought, my God, it was the devil. Mm-hmm. And Job said, and they meant it for evil, but God meant what I went through for good. Can you say amen? Anytime there's a divine appointment, God must protect you. Things must take place, but you need to just stay firm in what God has told you to do. Praise God. Verse 28.
But Paul cried with a loud voice,
saying,
do thyself no harm.
Don't do yourself no harm. And now the number 4 here, this scripture means salvation. It means salvation. Amen. And then the word number 4 means the weakness that's found in the world and in man. Only when men realize they weak or they gonna ask for help. Men will never ask, save me, deliver me, until they realize they don't have the strength to do it. Amen. They don't have the ability to do it. They don't have the wisdom to do it. And God has always showed us that anytime you can't do a thing, call me. Anytime you can't handle a situation, call me. Anytime the mountain's too big for you, call me. And God is saying that I am your strength even in times of weakness. Won't y'all say amen? Read number verse 29.
Then he called for a light.
And then he called for a light.
And sprang in.
Uh-huh.
And came trembling.
Yes.
And fell down before Paul and Silas.
He fell down. Now this is showing a spirit of humility. Amen. When you know you don't have the ability, you need to humble yourself and say, God, help me. The number, amen, 5 means grace and goodness. We got to come to a place where we got to humble ourselves. If you want honor, let me say, if you want honor, you got to humble yourself. that a lot of people want to be known and want their name to be known and want folk to listen. God ain't caring about your name, your church, your denomination. God is saying, if I'm going to bless you, you got to learn how to humble yourself under the mighty hand of God and resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Won't you say amen? The next verse number 30.
And brought them out.
And he brought them out.
And said,
Sirs,
what must I do to be saved?
Here it means divine deliverance. In verse 30, number 6 means manifestation of sin. He said, what must I do to be saved? In other words, I know I'm a sinner. I know something is wrong. And when you're in the divine appointment, God knows how to bring conviction upon sin. I'm convinced that folks have lost their conviction. They can talk about folks. They can go out and drink. They can go out and dance and then come to the house of God like nothing is going on. But I'm here to tell you, amen, if you really got some real conviction, you really save and sanctify, that certain thing will bring conviction. Lift your hands and praise God. Verse 31.
And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Believe.
And thou shalt be saved. And thy house.
The whole house. And what God said in verse 7, wholeness. It's important that the people of God be made whole. Families be made whole. Amen. And it means also the number of completion. God want to complete. Listen, God never starts anything unless he complete it. And anytime you repent, God will complete your life. Anytime you humble yourself, God will complete your journey. But you got to be willing to humble yourself and say, Lord, make me whole. The last verse, number 34.
And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house.
And here, number 34 verse means divine, or it means new release. Number 34, can you say amen? And number 8 means new birth, new beginning, or new creation. Can you say amen? And here the God said, I'm going to save this man's house. His conversion was not in vain. Because he not only got saved, but his whole house. Amen. God, when you're in the right place, God will save your sons. And God will save our daughters. And God will save our family members. Can you say amen? And all you got to do is continue to believe what God said. And know that God will bring about a new birth, a new beginning, and new creation in our life. Amen. The Bible says he not only was he saved, but his whole house. Meaning there's a new beginning in this man's house. That means that God said, now I brought new birth in your house. You were living under the Roman laws and you were lost. Amen. But you heard them pray. You heard them praise God. You thought surely you had lost your life. But you said, amen, what must I do to be saved? So it's obvious that he accepted Jesus Christ. He accepted the plan of salvation. And anytime you accept Jesus Christ, there's got to be a new life. There's got to be a new birth. It's got to be a new beginning. Can you say amen? All things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Won't y'all say amen? Paul the apostle, amen, living a life he lived, amen, was not just a rookie, amen, but he was a man seasoned. He went through some things early in his life, being a religious leader, being, amen, someone in the church, but not saved. Oh God, how many folks in the house of God not saved? They go to church. Amen. They carry Bibles, all colors, all sizes. Amen. Got prayer cloth and still not saved. Won't y'all say amen? Paul was a very zealous and religious leader, but he didn't know Jesus in the importance of his sin. But God had a divine appointment with Paul. Won't y'all say amen? And I don't care how ragged, amen, folks are living. I don't care how you got loved ones that's so mean, don't like a junkyard dog. God's got a divine appointment to bring them in. If you keep praying, if you keep praising God, he's got to break the yoke off their neck. Won't y'all say amen? The Bible said Apostle Paul, before he became a real true believer, amen, had to go through different process. And God took him through these things because every only thing he went through was divine appointment that God could bring him to this place. And I'm here to tell you, everything you've gone through, everything you're going to go through, God done brought you to a place where he said, now I want you to understand that it's not you, it's me. It ain't got nothing to do with how savior is me and how unfaithful is me, because there is a divine appointment that you got to meet with me. There's some things I want to talk to you about. There's some things I want to show you. There's some things I want to reveal to you. And I can't do it until you get in the right place under the divine appointment. Lift your hands and praise God. Can you say amen? And so Paul went through all this to come to this place, and Paul got delivered and got set free. And now God used Paul, amen, and Silas as they were doing the work of the Lord. Amen. That things were happening to them. You notice there was no complaining. There was no murmuring. Come out here. There was no why me? Why am I going through this? God, why I'm in prison like this? Listen, that's when you know, amen, you ain't. Don't understand divine appointment. Because when you understand who you are and who you serve, you know everything works for your good. Won't y'all say amen? Romans 8 and 28, it works for our good. There been some thing I'm sure all of us said, Lord, I didn't know how that was going to work for my good, because I was suffering. Sometimes suffering is divine appointment. Sometimes failure is divine appointment. Sometimes hurts and wounds are divine appointment. Sometimes being misled and being destroyed is divine appointment. So God can bring you to him. If you never hurt, you'll never know what healing is. If you've never been talked about, you'll never know what encouragement is. So God's got to let us go through some things to draw us to him. Lift your hands and praise God. I thought it was me. I thought it was my righteousness and my goodness. And God said, it was not your righteousness. It's not your goodness. It's mine. All righteousness belongs to me. If you do right, it's Jesus. Won't y'all say amen? If you talk right, it's Jesus. If you treat people right, it's Jesus. Because we have no righteousness of our own. But any righteousness we have is because of Christ. Won't y'all say amen? Joseph, and I'll be through here in a moment. Joseph, who went through tremendously, who was the baby boy of the family. Amen. Who was a man that God raised up as a child. Joseph, man, didn't have an understanding about telling dreams. All he knew, he was telling what he saw. He was, amen, didn't know he was on a divine assignment. And a lot of time, until you mature, you don't understand. Sometimes God's got you on divine assignment, and you don't know it because you're not mature enough to discern where you are. But the Bible said Joseph told everything about every dream. And every time he told him, the Bible said, and his brothers hated him. And they hated him. The more he talked about it, the more they hated him. Come on here. And I got news for you. The more when you're on divine appointment and you do what God said, dude, you got some haters. You got some haters, people over the wall. You got some haters, people under the table. You got some haters hoping that you fall and that you don't make it. But listen, I'm going to tell you right now, no weapon formed against all of us going to prosper. I don't care what the enemy formed. I don't care what he said. You and I have an assignment. We have a divine appointment. And until we close our eyes, we're pressing toward the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. Won't y'all say amen? Though the storm may come, you got to go. Amen. Though people try to stand the way, you got to go. God said, I have equipped you to make it. I made you a soldier. I called you out of nothing and built you up and made something out of you. And God said, you have a divine appointment with me to get to your destiny, and nobody can stop you but you. You're the only one can stop and lay down. But God said, as long as you get up and fight, as long as you pray and praise me, he said, I got to get you there. I don't care if the winds come. I don't care if the storms come. I don't care if folks leave you by yourself. God said, I'll never leave you, because you have a divine appointment I've got to get you to. Won't you say amen? Sometimes we wonder, Lord, why have I gone through this? And why am I going through this way? Could you made it simpler? Could you made it easier? But God said, if I did, you wouldn't know me. If I made it easier, you never know how to pray. If I made it easier, you never would have had faith to believe me. So God said, I know the way you should go. And because I know the way, I'm preparing the way for you. Won't you say amen? Even though you're walking sometime alone, God said, you're not alone. He said, I promise I'll never leave you. I promise I'll never forsake you. You and I have a divine appointment. We have a date with Jesus. We have a date with the angels. Won't y'all say amen? Joseph, Edmund, went through the process. He went through so bad that his brother sold him in slavery. They sold him in slavery. Told his daddy he was dead. Edmund, his daddy's heart was broken. But he didn't know it was divine appointment. Won't you say amen? Amen. They sold him in slavery. He had to go down to jail. He had to deal with a woman that tried to take him. And he resisted her. Won't you say amen? Sometime before you get to that place where you really strong, You got to go through hell. You got to go through people. You got to go through demons. But as long as you're in the will of God, as long as you say yes to the will of God, He will bring you there. He will get you there. He will exalt you. He will protect you. He will keep you. Can you say amen? You got to know I'm in God, divine will, and God divine appointment. It may not look like it now. It may look like I'm losing, but let me tell you, not losing, you're nothing but winning. You're on the right road. If you've been lied on, you're on the right road. If you've been talked about, you're on the right road. If you come under affliction, you're on the right road. If you cast down and cast back, you're on the right road. If folks don't like you and walk right by you, won't even speak, you're on the right road. Tell somebody, I'm in God's divine appointment. I won't be moved. I won't be shaken. I won't turn from that God done gave me to do. Lift your voice and say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Yeah, Lord. Tell God yes. Bless His name. Reach over and touch a neighbor. Say, I'm in God's divine appointment. I've been shaken, but I'm still standing. I said, I've been shaken by the cares of this life. I've been shaken by the afflictions. I've been shaken by what people say. I've been shaken by the news. I've been shaken by the family. But I must report today, I'm still standing, giving Him praise and giving Him glory. Lift your voice and say yes. Say yes, say yes, say yes, Lord. Oh, bless His name. Hallelujah. Divine. And the word divine means Theos, or God. And if God be for us, if God be for you, if God be with you, if God be in you, how can you not make it? Won't you say amen? You may be seated. Lord have mercy. By divine appointment, Paul and Silas had a divine appointment to be in jail. And some things God, with divine appointment, it doesn't sit well with us. Come on, church. How many know since you've been saved, some things just don't sit well with you. When God starts shifting you and start pulling on you, start dealing with you. Come on, church. Some things just don't sit well with you. And sometimes things come in your life to interfere, to cause you not to be what God said do. But God is saying, I'm with you. Yes, storm, listen. We all going to have some interruptions. We all going to have some interruptions. But that's what it is. It's just interrupting. It's not going to stop what God's going to do. Because when I get through, I heard it said we're going to bounce back. Can you say amen? So when I get through with that, I'm going to bounce back and tell God, thank you for the glory. Thank you for the anointing. Come on here. Thank you for the power of God. Lift your hands if you will this morning. And I want you to say with one voice, by God's divine appointment, I'm still standing. I'm still in God's will. And I praise Him for victory. I praise Him for the outcome. I praise Him for the outcome. I know I'm going to win. I praise Him for the outcome. I know I got the victory. I praise for the outcome. I know I'm going to get an overflow. I praise for the outcome. I know there's a fresh anointing coming. I know there's a new birth coming. So I'm praising Him for the outcome. Before it happens, I'm praising God already. Hallelujah. Hey, Ayah Babash. Hey, bless your name. Bless your name. Bless your name, Jesus. 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 Jesus had a divine appointment, and He had to keep it anyhow. And before He started ministry, The Bible said, and the Spirit of God drove him into the wilderness. And while in the wilderness, he had a divine appointment with Lucifer himself. He could not escape it. He could not overlook it. But he had to be there because God said, this time, after you defeat the devil in these three areas, then your ministry is going to start. He said, I can't start the ministry until you overcome the lust of your eyes, the lust of your flesh, and the pride of life. I know you're not going to yield because you're the word of God. He said, but you got to go through this. You got to go through for the saints' sake. You got to go through for the church's sake. You got to go through for people to see and understand that greater one that's in you is the Holy Ghost. Won't you say amen? I heard the devil said, if you be the Son of God, why don't you, I know you're hungry, won't you cast these stones and make them bread? But I heard Jesus say, because I know I have a divine appointment, amen, with death and with God, he said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out the mouth of God. And the devil left for a season, but he came right back. Won't y'all say amen? He said, let me take you up high on the pinnacle and show you everything and the glory of this world that I give you. Won't you say amen? But Jesus knew and said, listen, all this is my Father. All this belongs to me. I won't bow down to any. I don't want to bow down to God. Won't you say amen? And the devil left another time. Amen. Then the Bible said the last time he said, amen, I want you. Amen. Just bow down to me. Amen. And give me praise. But Jesus said, listen here, thou shalt have no other God. Thou shalt have no other God. There's only one God, God Jehovah. And the Bible said, when he said those words, the enemy left him. And then the Bible said, the angels came and ministered to Jesus, because now it's time for ministry. It's not ministry to learn. You got to go through some stuff. You got to face some things. And you got to pass your test. And then there shall come a release of God's anointing on your life. Lift your hands and give God praise. We have a little small things and crying, whining, like little children. That's why God always called the people of God children of Israel. He never called them adults because they always act like children. If something go wrong, they whining and crying and still going to the word, going back to the altar, going back to the foundation where you were built upon, and that is prayer and the word of the living God. Won't you say amen? So I say this morning, I don't care how you try to run. You call to preach, you have a divine appointment. You call the pastor, you have a divine appointment with God. You call to be an evangelist, you're trying to do something else, you have a divine appointment, and you will not escape it. And you will not escape it. Won't you say amen? If I change my name, change your name all you want to. Change your hair, change your clothes. Change your sex. You still have divine appointment with the God who created you, who made you. Won't y'all say, lift your hands and praise God. If we get in line with the word of God, Paul and Silas was in line with God's word. They didn't mind going to prison for his sake, but they knew what to do when they got there. Listen, when you get in trouble, you got to know what to do. You got to know who to call upon. You got to know how to praise and worship God and give him glory. Amen. And things will happen. Finances have come against us. We have come against lack in some of areas. Amen. But crying ain't going to help you. Begin to praise God and worship him anyhow. And say, Lord, I thank you because you own everything. I praise you because the silver and gold is yours. I don't have it right now, but I'm going to praise you for it. You're going to make the way for me. Come on here. Praise God. You got to act as though you have it through your prayer and through your praise. God will honor you when you honor him. I think Proverbs 3:9 said, if you honor the Lord with your substance, what he would do. We'll take money that God give us and spend it somewhere else. We'll take the blessing that God blesses with and put it on something else instead of putting it in the kingdom work. The people that are mature now understand kingdom principles and kingdom ministry. And those who are still children still understand church work and church duty. Won't y'all say amen? It's time for us to grow up and realize we're operating in the kingdom principles. Amen. And God has a divine appointment to reveal to us and share the things you need to know. Lift your hands and worship God for just a moment. Say, Lord, the jailer said, Lord, what must I do? I know I've come short. What must I do? I know, God, that the God y'all serve is real. I heard y'all pray. I heard y'all praise him. I heard y'all thank him. And yet y'all were in stocks. Stocks meaning in a position. Not just with your feet through the hole, but stretched out. And your feet through the hole, meaning it's uncomfortable. But I heard y'all praise. I heard you praise a God I never heard of. I heard you pray to a God that's everlasting. And then something began to take place. Suddenly, earthquake came. Praise God. Listen, how many of you need some sudden thing to happen for us in the kingdom? Sudden breakthroughs and sudden ministries. Come on here. Sudden finances. Without a warning, just begin suddenly, God began to pour it out on you. Hallelujah. Well, I'm saying, give him a praise this morning. Open your mouth and give God a praise here. Open your mouth and just give him a praise. And if you want to, give him a praise. Open your mouth and praise him for it. Open your mouth and praise him for it. Open your mouth and give him the glory for it. Praise you for doing it, God. Praise God. I will not be in prison. I will not be enclosed. I will not be denied. Because God, you've given the Spirit of the Holy Ghost. And he that the Son of Man set free is free indeed. So I have the right to praise you and thank you. Have a right to give you glory. I will not stay in prison. I will not be bound by any. But I will worship you and praise you. Anytime you're in prison is a confinement. But how many know God has brought us out of prison? He brought us out of sin. He brought us out of shame. Come on here. So you got a right to praise him. You got a right to thank him. You got a right to run if you want to. Jump if you want to. But God said, I brought you out to give me praise. I brought you through to magnify my name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Paul and Silas showed us one thing, that they wasn't bound, and yet in prison, they were not bound. And any time you got bills, got you crying, got family members depressing you, got your job about to make you lose your salvation, you need to understand, you need to give God a praise. You need to give him a sacrificial praise and tell God, I refuse to be in this place. I know who I am in you. I refuse to let the devil do this to me. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. I got the power to speak it and power to declare it and power to say anything, and you will do it for us. Somebody said, praise God. By God's divine appointment, he brought them out and brought them through. And so this morning, you and I have gone through some things. But guess what? He brought us out. If he brought you out, tell somebody next to you, he brought me out. He brought me out. He really did. He brought me out. I didn't see no way out, but he brought me out. I wasn't sure how I was going to get out. I knew I was going to get out, but I didn't know how. That's God's business. My business is to praise him and thank him and say, get me out. Praise. And God be to open the doors and get me out. Want some? Praise God. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. We have a divine appointment with him. Right now, you're in God's divine will. There are things happening to you that sometimes you don't even understand. The things you're going through now, say, Lord, I don't know why in the world I'm going through this. Just know that if you're in Christ, he's leading you somewhere greater than where you are. And what I love about God, he's always leading us somewhere greater than where we are. Because where we are now, sometimes people get comfortable. So God has allowed something to happen to get you uncomfortable. How many know that's true? Sometimes I was just so comfortable and, ooh, I love Jesus. I love the saints and we just all family. Then all hell broke loose. You said, Lord, why did this happen? God said, because really your purpose is to go forward. And not to sit and play, but it's to go forward to win souls. Do you not know we are witnesses for him to win souls? And not trying to win one another. Win sinners and backsliders. Can you say amen? We're getting ready to go this morning. But I know God is saying, spoke my heart, he said, divine appointment. And even though you may be in prison, God said, divine appointment. Even though you may be going through heartaches right now, God said, divine appointment. Even though your finances may be strapped, you may use that term, God said, divine appointment. Like everything you're going through, you say, Lord, I don't know why God said, divine appointment for you. Stay in my will. Stay in my word. Stay in my grace. Come on here, stay with me, God said. And I got to bring you out and bring you through. Don't give up now. Don't give out now. Stay with it. And you'll see the benefits and the manifestation of the power of God being manifested in you. Do you know how you have an idea what Christ has sowed in us? The seed that's in us. Oh my God. The seed of righteousness in us. The seed that give him glory in everything that we do. We get ready to pray this morning. If you were here, he said, preach, I'm so glad I heard that word, because I'm telling you, I was going through. And I want you to come and let us pray with you at the altar. We just want to pray. I'm not going to, sister, that's right, sister, yes, that's all right. I just want them to come. We're going to pray with them. I want you to come. If you're going through right now, you said, preacher, you don't know. I'm facing some stuff. I want to just speak a word over you this morning. I just want to speak a word over you in the name of Jesus. And this word will loose you and will set you free. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Help them praise God as they come. Let's worship him and praise him. Hallelujah. Look around and said, this is God's divine appointment. I see that now. I see that now as I see the altar. As I see the needs of God's people. God said, there was divine appointment that you be here today. Hallelujah. That we speak the word of God. Don't draw back from God. Don't draw back from the will of God. Don't draw back from him. But declare warfare on the enemy. And said, I have the power in my mouth to speak. I have the power, God, to speak. And I was beginning to declare some things. And God's going to change. Father, I praise you. I thank you for the people, God, that are here at the altar. I thank you, God, this is your divine appointment for them today. They may not be in this place next week, but today they're in this place. And I pray, Lord, because the word of God is real. And the word of God is right. And the enemy has done his best to destroy many of them. To depress them. Loved ones acting crazy. Children out of line. Jobs threatened. Going through in our own body, in our own mind. But I thank you today, God. You had them in mind today. You had every one of the altar in mind today. To let them know they have a divine appointment with you. That you're going to speak a word to deliver them and set them free. I speak peace now. Peace to everyone that feels. I speak peace to your mind and peace to your situation and peace in your body. And Satan, you're a lying wonder. You will not cancel out what God's got for them. You will not take that which God's going to give them. God said, I'm going to visit you. And God said, hold on and wait on me because I'm coming to you. I'm coming to show you what to do. If I have to give you amen, give you revelation, now I'll give it to you. So you'll know where you are in me. God, I thank you for building up the people of God. Building up their faith. Building up their hope. Building up their strength. When they walk away from the altar, they walking away not only saved, they walking away delivered. They walking away, God, encouraged that God, you have heard their cry. You've heard their plead. And now you're sending help. And now you're sending strength. And now you're sending fresh anointing. And now you're sending God help from on high. I praise you for it. I thank you for it. Every soul here, at the altar, God, stand in need of your help and your strength. And I thank you for divine favor. I thank you for divine favor. I thank you for divine healing. I thank you for salvation. I thank you for the gift of the Holy Ghost. I thank you for bringing home backsliders in the name of Jesus. And I receive now that which you have for me. I open my mouth and praise you. I open my heart and thank you. I give you the praise right now. I give you the praise right now. I give you the praise right now. Open your mouth and praise him. Open your mouth wide and praise him. Oh God. Oh God. Yeah. Oh God. Break the yoke. Break the band of the enemy. Break the depression spirit. Bind the suicide spirit. Bind it in Jesus' name. I will not die, but I will live to declare the works of the Lord. I shall live and not die. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Now I want you at the altar, begin to praise God like you crazy. Praise God like you out your mind. Don't worry about who's next to you. This is your time. This is your time for deliverance. This is your time for help. This is your time for God to do something for you. In the name of Jesus, this is your time. Do it for him, God. And I praise you in the name of Jesus. Break the yoke. Break the chain. Break the habit. In Jesus, encourage my brother. He can make it because you're going to help him. Somebody pray God. This is God's divine appointment for you. Somebody praise God with it. Oh, come on and praise God. God has set it up. And God has set us up to be here, to praise him and thank him and give him the glory. You're coming out. You're going to get your breakthrough. He's got to bring you out. Oh. Hallelujah. Bless your name. We don't need no music. Come on, clap your hands. We don't need no music. We don't need no music. It's in your mouth. It's in your hands. It's in your dance. Come on. It's in your mouth. It's in your hands. It's in your dance. Come on, praise God. Is in your mouth, is in your hand, is in your dance. Come on. Hallelujah. Oh, say it. God said, I'll do it. Say it. God said, I'll do it. Praise me, and I'll do it. Clap your hands and break the yoke of the enemy. Give God a dance of the Holy Ghost. Come on and praise God. Oh, yeah, God. My God. Oh, divine appointment. For deliverance, for healing, for breakthrough. It is your appointment for me. Oh, I'm going to praise you for it too. I'm going to thank you for it. Whoa. He can't stop you. He can't stop you. You're on your way. He can't stop you. God is for you. And God is with you. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Oh, bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Oh. I'm in his will, and the blessings of the Lord make him rich and add no sorrow. Wipe my tears
and give me joy after I have cried all night long. Come on, praise him. Whoa. Yes, sir. I almost missed it. I almost missed it. But thank be to God, he led me to this place just in time. He led me just in time. He spoke to my heart just in time. I was going somewhere else, but he ordained that I be here. Oh, oh, I'm gonna praise him. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Oh. That's it. I shout a victory right in the devil's face. I shout a victory right in the devil's face. Oh. Woo-hoo. Bless your name. Thank God. Well, well, well. The glory is here. And the angels are present to bring deliverance. You just got to reach up and get it. God said this is a divine appointment to change your life and to shift you from another place from where you are. Come on. Come on, praise him. Come on, thank him. You want to go back to your seat, go back, but praise him. Hallelujah. Ah, my soul cries out. Ha, ba, 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 sha. Thank you that you love me. Thank you that you care. Come on and praise him. Oh. Oh, God. Yes, you have a divine appointment and the seed got to come forth. Hallelujah. Woo. Yes, sir. There will be manifestation. Go on and praise him. Holy Ghost, take over. Take over, Holy Ghost. Take over. Holy Ghost, take over. Oh, yeah, ba, 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 ba. Angel of the Lord. Oh, no, 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 shut now. Hey, Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Take over. Wash us. Cleanse us. Deliver us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will praise him. I will thank him. Thank you. Every trial, every test, every situation. Thank you.